Hey everyone, welcome to our channel. Today we're going to show you how to smoke deliciously tender chicken on the pit barrel cooker. This method will give you juicy, flavorful chicken with just an absolutely beautiful smoky aroma. So let's get started. First things first, let's prepare our chicken. You'll need a whole chicken, or you can use chicken pieces if you prefer. I'm using a whole chicken that clocks in at about over 5 pounds. It's been sitting in a brine that consists of water and about a handful of lemon pepper for about 24 hours. I found that 5 pounds of chicken is the perfect size to fit to a gallon-sized bag. Next, it's time to take this bird out of the bag, rinse the chicken in the sink, then pat, pat, pat all that extra moisture and liquid. The whole point of this step is to get the skin as dry as possible. This will allow for our skin to get nice and crispy during the cook. If there's too much moisture, then the skin will be soggy and rubbery. Still delicious, just not crispy. Also, this step will allow for better coverage of our canola oil binder and for our rub. Next, we will scratch cast the chicken, which is just a fancy way of saying that we are going to remove the backbone and flatten the chicken. I needed two hands, so I put the camera down. Here you can see that the backbone has been removed, and I took it one step further and I separated the chicken into two halves. This will allow me to season each side easier. Next, I grabbed the lemon pepper and seasoned both sides. The seasoning wasn't evenly distributed, so I put the camera down again and rubbed each half of the chicken to evenly distribute the seasoning. Now let's talk about hook placement. Since we removed the backbone, there isn't anything holding the top and the bottom together but skin. I didn't want the bottom to fall off during the smoke, so I inserted a second hook to double ensure nothing was going to happen. Now that we have our chicken seasoned and our hooks inserted, it is time to talk about firing up the smoker. I have filled up the charcoal basket about 3/4 of the way with charcoal briquettes. I also filled up a charcoal chimney, which we will light and then dump onto the charcoal basket at a later point. Next, I adjusted the damper to about the width of my pinky. Make sure to check the owner's manual for instructions on how far open you should have your damper based off of your location and elevation. Onto our charcoal chimney. This is actually an example of what not to do, rather than what you should be doing. As you can see, I put entirely too much paper and then the chimney on top. The chimney isn't level and it is hard to light, and it runs the risk of tipping over, which you're going to see in just one moment. What you want to do is have the chimney on a level surface. You want to line the bottom of the chimney evenly so that it is easier to light. And if you don't want to use paper or the charcoal bag in this instance, then you can use what they call a tumbleweed. You're able to find these at any of those big box stores. Now that I almost burned my fingers off, we're going to let this sit for a couple of minutes while the coals ignite. So the coals have ignited but aren't quite ready, as indicated by the thick, dirty, gray smoke. We aren't going to dump the charcoal until all the coals have ignited and have ashed over. We should have a clear blue smoke indicating that the coals are ready, just like this that you see in the video. Now that the coals are ready, we'll dump them on top of the charcoal basket and put the basket at the bottom of the pit barrel cooker and get ready to hang our chicken. But before we do that, we do give the unlit coals a chance to ignite. We will also put some wood on the coals. I'm using a 50-50 mix of applewood and hickory as my flavoring wood. Our smoker is now between 265 and 270 degrees, and we are ready to go, so let's hang some chicken. I have my temperature probes inserted into the breast, which is the thickest part of this chicken, and we'll be shooting for 165 degrees. After about 1.5 hours, I was getting an alert from my thermometer stating that we had reached our desired internal temperature. This smoked a lot faster than anticipated. I think that was due to it being 95 degrees outside on this day. At this point, I'm going to take the chicken off the smoker and let it rest for about 10 minutes, maybe longer. We were hand shredding this chicken to use in salads, tacos, quesadillas, and as a main entree for our dinners throughout the week. So rather than scorching my hands while shredding, I waited until it was easier to handle. Before we go, I did want to provide a pro tip for putting out the coals. Take the basket out of the pit barrel cooker, place the basket in the small can barrel, and make sure all the dampers are fully closed. After about 10 minutes, the coals are no longer lit. Thanks for watching. If you found this video valuable, go ahead and check out our other videos. And until next time, keep those fires burning and those taste buds tingling.